صباح الخير ومرحبا بكم جميعا في مكتبة اسكندرية. Good morning and welcome everybody in the Library of Alexandria. My name is Ismail Sirajuddin and I'm the director of the Library of Alexandria and I enjoy the title Librarian of Alexandria since it joins with a great tradition of eminent librarians who also made major contributions to astronomy, such as Eratosthenes, the third director of the library. And I'm proud to carry that title, although the library has been here and functioning for 2,300 years, it has had a slight hiatus of 1,600 years, in which we were sort of closed down. But here we are, same place, same services, and you're all welcome here indeed. Today is a special day where we have the privilege of welcoming our friends from the International Planetarium Society from all over the world, and welcome each and every one. And the city of Alexandria is not just host to the Library of Alexandria, it is, of course, itself the city of Alexander and Ptolemy, the city of Cleopatra and Antony, the city of history, the city of modern cosmopolitanism, the city of Kafafis, Ungaretti, and other poets. It is also the city of Durell. It is our city. And on behalf of the governor of Alexandria, it is my pleasure to invite General Safaeddin Kamel to present a few words of welcome on behalf of Alexandria. لواء صفاء تفضل يا فندم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الأستاذ الدكتور إسماعيل سراج الدين مدير مكتبة الإسكندرية، العالم المصري الكبير الأستاذ الدكتور فاروق الباز، العالم العربي الشهير جورج صليبة، السيدات والسادة ضيوف الإسكندرية الكرام، أود في البداية أن أشكركم جميعاً على هذه الدعوة الكريمة لحضور الجلسة الافتتاحية للمؤتمر العشرين للمجتمع الدولي للقباب السماوية، والذي يعقد للمرة الأولى في أفريقيا والشرق الأوسط، وأن أنقل لكم تحيات السيد اللواء عادل لبيب محافظ الأسكندرية التي حالت ظروف طارئة دون حضوره هذا المؤتمر. والواقع أن هذا المؤتمر الدولي الهام يأتي في سياق النشاط المتميز التي تقوم به مكتبة الأسكندرية في خدمة العلم والثقافة، تلك المكتبة التي أضافت الكثير لمدينة الأسكندرية وجعلتها من المدن الثقافية الكبرى على خريطة العالم. وهنا أجد لزاماً علي أن أتوجه بأخلص الآيات والشكر والتقدير لمدير المكتبة النشيط الدكتور إسماعيل سراج الدين على جهوده المتواصلة وعطائه الدائم في سبيل تحقيق رسالة المكتبة محلياً وأقليمياً وعالمياً. وإذا كان هذا المؤتمر عن القباب السماوية الذي ينظمه مركز القبة السماوية بالمكتبة يعكس ثقافة التاريخ القرن الحادي والعشرين، فإنه يمثل في الواقع امتداداً لتاريخ عريق شهدته الأسكندرية عندما كانت مكتبتها القديمة مهد للعلم والفلك ومنارة لثقافة العالم آنذاك، كما إنه يمثل قيمة ومثلاً للقباب السماوية كوسيلة من الوسائل الحديثة والمتقدمة لنشر المعرفة العلمية من خلال العروض الأكاديمية التي تعرضها، خاصة ما يتعلق منها بعلم الفلك والفضاء والأجرام السماوية وغير ذلك من المجالات الرحبة والواسعة للعلم. ولعل تلك الوسائل هي أبرز ما تقدمه القبة السماوية من معرفة خاصة للشباب من الباحثين ولطلاب المدارس والمعاهد المختلفة في وقت أصبح فيه العلم هو أساس التقدم والتنمية. ولا شك أن القبة السماوية إحدى هذه الأسس والوسائل. السيدات والسادة الحضور، يسعدني في هذه المناسبة المتميزة أن أرحب باسم أبناء الأسكندرية جميعاً بعالم الفضاء المصري الدكتور فاروق الباز الذي يحظى بتقدير واحترام كل المصريين لإسهاماته وأنجازاته الكبيرة للعالم في بحوث الفضاء، وهو الذي يأمل دائماً أن يكون العلم هو أساس العمل للارتقاء بالوطن في جميع المجالات. ولعل مشروعه الرائد عن ممر التنمية والتعمير هو واحد من المشروعات الكبرى التي ارتبطت باسمه، والأمل معقود على تنفيذه لمواجهة مشكلات التكدس السكاني في الوادي والدلتا. كذلك أجد لزاماً علي أن أحيي وأرحب بالضيوف الأعزاء الذين شرفت بهم الأسكندرية اليوم من العلماء والباحثين المتخصصين في علوم الفلك والقباب السماوية من كل أنحاء العالم، وأرجو لهم طيب الإقامة في الأسكندرية. أيها السادة الحضور، إن في نهاية كلمتي أود أن أذكر أن الأسكندرية تسير بخطى واسعة نحو التطوير والتحديث وفق خطة علمية متكاملة، وأنه لا شك في أننا سنستفيد كثيراً من توصيات مؤتمركم هذا في تحديث هذه الخطة وزيادة الدور الثقافي للأسكندرية والمكتبة كنافذة لمصر على العالم ونافذة للعالم على مصر. مرة أخرى لكم مني ألف تحية والتمنيات الطيبة بالإقامة السعيدة والتوفيق فيما تصلون إليه من توصيات في هذا المؤتمر، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
It is now my great pleasure and privilege to invite Dr. Tom Mason, Armagh Planetarium College Hill, Armagh, Northern Ireland, to come and speak on behalf of all our guests whom we are so proud to welcome in Alexandria today.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Sarah Galdean, Your Excellencies, honored guests, and fellow planetarians, Salaam Alaikum, and welcome to Alexandria. This is as tidy as I come, so this is a very auspicious occasion. I'd like to mention that this is a landmark conference in many different ways. The three most important are that it is the first time that we have come to the continent of Africa. It's the first time that we have come to the Arabic-speaking world, and the first time into the Islamic world. And I think that each of those landmarks are worth celebrating. And I hope that as a consequence of what we do here, we may actually see an Arabic-speaking affiliate to IPS in due course. I was going to say in short order, but I know that things work a little more slowly in Africa. I'd especially like to thank our hosts. I'm very sorry that my good friend, Engineer Hoda El Makati, cannot be here today, but I'm sure that you will join with me in thanking her and her team, far too many to name, apart from Dr. Umar. He and I have shared a partnership in this, and I hope that you will benefit from that in the days to come. Last night, I was most encouraged at our reception to meet several new colleagues from Africa that I hadn't met before. One in particular comes from a city that I talk about often. It's Khartoum. And when I show satellite images to the little people in our planetarium, one can see the silvery thread of the Nile running back from the Mediterranean, and then there's a huge gap, and then there's this huge bright light, and that's the city of Khartoum. So a special welcome to her as well. I'm also pleased to note that we have had the support, and you're about to hear from them, of not just one but two education ministers and the Minister of Tourism. And I think that, again, that emphasizes, in my view, the importance of how planetariums interact with their public. We're working not only to educate little people, children, students, but their parents and grandparents. It's a lifelong learning experience. And the hook of astronomy is a very useful way of impelling people into looking for things that they may not have thought of, and we all share the same sky. The last thing I'd like to leave you with is an image. Normally I speak to images, it's my stock and trade, so it's a bit, I feel a bit bereft not having slides. But I want to paint a picture for you, which I'm sure you will find in your own mind. When I was last here speaking on this same platform, I showed a video clip, and it was from the European Space Agency, and it was of a rocket launching from Kazakhstan. Its payload was a Martian Explorer payload heading off to explore Mars, which my colleague Farouk here works on often. And I was struck by the fact that the launch vehicle, the rocket, was actually built to carry nuclear weapons. And around 40 years ago, someone had the bright idea to strap a human on and launched Yuri Gagarin into space. And since then, I'm glad to say that those rockets that we designed for rather more evil purposes have actually been put to better use. I hope that our conference will lead to lots of new things happening, and I'm especially hopeful that you people here who have traveled from many parts of the world to attend, I think we have 44 countries represented, I'm hoping that you will take the opportunity to network, and as I've often said before, taking ideas from other people to use in your own planetarium is a jolly good thing. It's not stealing, it's something that we're all keen to share. And on that note, I'd like to thank you, welcome you here, and I look forward to meeting more of you later in the conference. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Tom Mason. And now it's my pleasure to invite Dr. Hisham Zazour on behalf of His Excellency the Minister of Tourism.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning to all of you, and I welcome you all to Egypt, Alexandria, and to the library. And I would like you to excuse me. I'll deliver my speech in Arabic. Thank you. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. سعادة السيد الدكتور إسماعيل سراج الدين مدير مكتبة الإسكندرية. سعادة العالم المصري الجليل الأستاذ الدكتور فاروق الباز. سعادة الباحث العربي الشهير الأستاذ الدكتور جورج صليبة. السادة الحضور الكريم. إنه لمن دواعي سروري أن أشارك اليوم نيابة عن معالي السيد زهير جرانة وزير السياحة في افتتاح المؤتمر العشرين للمجتمع الدولي للقباب السماوية 2010 مع هذا الجمع المتميز من العلماء والباحثين المتخصصين في علوم الفلك والقباب السماوية، والذي يعد أهم وأكبر مؤتمر دوري في عالم القباب السماوية، حيث يقام للمرة الأولى في مصر، وهو ما يعتبر دليلاً وتعزيزاً لمكانة مصر باعتبارها مهد للعلم والحضارة من قديم الأزل. كما يسعدني أن تكون الإسكندرية هي محل اختيار إقامة هذا المؤتمر نظرا لتزامن موعد انعقاده مع فعاليات الاحتفال باختيار الإسكندرية عاصمة للسياحة العربية لهذا العام، لما لهذه المدينة من مقومات فريدة أهلتها للجمع بين المكانة المتميزة سياحيا وعلميا وحضاريا، حيث مكتبة الإسكندرية التي تعد معلما سياحيا وعلميا فريدا أهل الإسكندرية لهذا الاختيار، فضلا عن معالمها التاريخية الأخرى. وليس أدل على الدور الريادي لمكتبة الإسكندرية في نشر القيم والثقافات العلمية للمجتمع المصري والعربي من أن تشهد انعقاد هذا المؤتمر الهام بها. وأود في هذا المقام أن أنتهز الفرصة لأتقدم بخالص الشكر لمجلس المجتمع الدولي للقباب السماوية لاختيار مكتبة الإسكندرية لإقامة هذا المؤتمر. السيدات والسادة، لقد أصبحت السياحة مؤخرا من أهم الصناعات التي تؤثر وتتأثر بشكل واضح بالعديد من المجالات، ومن منطلق أن تقدم الدول يتأتى بشكل أساسي من خلال العلم والتكنولوجيا، وإيمانا بالدور الذي يجب أن تلعبه السياحة في النهوض بالمجتمع من خلال التكامل بين السياحة والعلم والتكنولوجيا. فقد قامت وزارة السياحة بالمشاركة في تطوير قاعة عرض القبة بمكتبة الأسكندرية، إدراكا منها لدور القبة السماوية كنقطة مركزية للسياحة التعليمية الترفيهية في مصر بصفة عامة والأسكندرية بصفة خاصة، حيث شارك معالي السيد وزير السياحة في افتتاح عرض القبة السماوية بعد تجديدها باستخدام أحدث الوسائل التكنولوجية في عام 2009. وإذ كنا نتحدث عن الأهمية المتزايدة لصناعة السياحة بوجه عام، فإن صناعة السياحة المصرية أصبحت ركيزة أساسية للاقتصاد القومي المصري، حيث حققت السياحة المصرية للاقتصاد المصري 12.5 مليون سائح في نهاية عام 2009، وساهمت بحصيلة قدرها 10.6 مليار دولار أمريكي للخزينة المصرية، فضلا عن مساهمتها في سوق العمل بنسبة 12.6% من العمالة المباشرة وغير المباشرة. وتوج المقصد السياحي المصري المقصد رقم واحد على مستوى الشرق الأوسط وأفريقيا، والمركز رقم 21 ضمن أفضل 50 مقصد سياحي متميز على المستوى العالمي، فضلا عن طبقا لإحصائيات منظمة السياحة العالمية عن عام 2009. ومن هذا المنطلق فإن وزارة السياحة المصرية قد انتهكت استراتيجية تعتمد بشكل أساسي ورئيسي على تنوع المنتج السياحي، ومن هنا كان الاهتمام بالسياحة التعليمية وسياحة المؤتمرات كمنتج سياحي، وهو ما يسهم بدور كبير في تشجيع الحركة السياحية. ولا أريد أن أطيل على حضراتكم، لذا انتهت هذه الفرصة لتوجه بالشكر لكل القائمين على هذا المؤتمر، متمنيا لكل المشاركين مؤتمرا ناجحا ومثمرا بإذن الله في عودة إلى الأسكندرية مهد علم الفلك. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Now the Library of Alexandria is very closely allied with the University of Alexandria. They are part and parcel of the same thing. After all, the ancient library was also a university and an academy of science and a research center. And so it was not unusual that it was from the University of Alexandria that the first calls for the revival of the ancient library were launched. And it is on land donated by the University of Alexandria that the library now stands. And in fact, the auditorium where we are was initially built by the University of Alexandria for its own students before being donated as its first contribution out of many to the new Library of Alexandria. And so it is with great honor and pleasure that I call on Dr. Rushdie Zahran on behalf of Dr. Hind Hanafi to speak on behalf of the University of Alexandria.
Thank you, Dr. Ismail. Dr. Ismail Saragheddin, Director of the Library of Alexandria. Mr. Safauddin Mustafa Kamel, on behalf of the Governor of Alexandria, Mr. Hisham Zazour, Ministry of Tourism, Dr. Tom Mason, Chairman of the International Planetarium Society, Dr. Farouk Elbaz, Director of the Center for Sensing and Research, Boston University, Dr. George Saliba, Professor of Arabic and Islamic Studies, Columbia University, honorable and distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning, everyone. On behalf of President Hind Hanafi, President of Alexandria University, who was unable to join us this morning due to some other commitment outside the country, and on behalf of Alexandria University, I would like to welcome you all to Alexandria, the pearl of the Mediterranean, the place where culture, sciences, arts all met and have been disseminated to humanity to spread knowledge and civilization all over the world. It is a great pleasure for Alexandria University to share some precious moment with you this morning during the opening ceremony of the 20th International Planetarium Society Conference, IPS 2010. The conference this time, back to Alexandria, the cradle of astronomy, emphasizes the role played by Alexandria and its ancient great library in enriching knowledge and sciences in many fields, like physics, mathematics, medicine, geography, architecture, astronomy, etc. The relation between Alexandria University and the library, as Dr. Ismail Saragiddin mentioned, is such an ancient and historical one, embraced by the city of Alexandria, characterized by its central position in the world. From its very beginning, Alexandria was destined to perform several functions as a Greek city-state, as the capital of Egypt, as the center for the world trade, and as a center for learning. These multiple functions attract many scientists and scholars from various cultures. Many distinguished astronomy scholars, such as Eratosthenes, Ptolemies, and Hypatia, all lived in Alexandria. Since the early ages, men always looked at the sky, thought about its secrets, which were always of great interest to him. He could see a number of myths, which he drew from his own life and beliefs. Yet the relation, man and the sky, is not only restricted to imagination, but it has become a science studied by all civilizations of the ancient world and used in everyday life. With time, such a science turned to be of great importance. Thanks to what was achieved in modern life, like many of the new technologies, we now know a lot about such far, distant, and obscure world. However, what we know is actually a small part of the secret of such a great universe. Understanding space is a quite necessary matter to face challenges of the 21st century. We should understand the universe in order to be able to imagine our destiny. Indeed, many tries have been made by simulating the outer spacious universe. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I would like to bring to your attention that the Department of Physics at the Faculty of Science in Alexandria University is starting a leading and unique program of space science among Egyptian universities. To ensure the success of the space program through generations to come, we must have simple but compelling long-term goals and coherent, thoughtful plans to achieve them. Finally, may you all allow me to extend my sincerest appreciation to Dr. Ismail Saragiddin for inviting Alexandria University to the opening ceremony of the IPS prestigious conference organized jointly by the Planetarium Science Center of the Library. With all my best wishes for a successful and enjoyable conference, I wish you interactive, successful, and fruitful discussions leading to plausible and sound recommendations that can be implemented and that will enhance the role of the planetariums in informal education. May you all have an enjoyable stay in Alexandria and a safe trip back home. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Rushdie, for these kind words. Now we have a special guest that it gives me enormous pleasure to call upon to say a few words at this ceremony. And it is very appropriate that we should do so because Tom Mason spoke about how our vocation, our mission in Planetaria involved reaching out to the little people and their parents. Well, Dr. Yusri Gamal has not only been a close friend and associate of the library since its initiation, and he was the vice president of the Arab Academy for Science and Technology, and then as Minister of Education, he launched many programs that we in the Library of Alexandria, and especially with the Planetarium Science Center, were privileged to collaborate on. From a special website to introduce science to science teachers in the ministry under his aegis. We had our friend, Nobelist Georges Charpak, and others present in launching that particular effort, to the science clubs that we have organized in a number of schools that were under his supervision here in Alexandria. Now we have over 100, going to 300 this year, Dr. Yusri. And many other programs, including his ever-present support to every activity that we have launched from the planetarium in the Library of Alexandria, including our science fairs. Dr. Yusri Gamal is now, having left the Ministry of Education, has taken on the duties of being the chairman of the board of a new prestigious collaboration between Japan and Egypt to launch the Egyptian-Japanese University for Science and Technology here in Burj Al Arab. And he is now supervising the construction from the bottom up of this great science edifice. So, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce Dr. Yusri Gamal.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thank you very much, Dr. Ismail Siraj-ed-Din, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me great pleasure to join you today for the opening ceremony of the 20th conference that's held at the auspices of the Bibliotheca Alexandrina. It's a pleasure for me today to witness this remarkable event, first time in Africa and first time in this part of the world. As a former Minister of Education, we used to join forces with the Library of Alexandria to avail to our young students the opportunity to experience sciences and to encourage our young generation to love sciences, to love doing experiments, to do things in groups. And Bibliotheca Alexandria was the place. We used to see this wonderful look after being at the planetarium. I used to discuss with groups that had a tour within the Library of Alexandria and had the opportunity to witness some displays at the planetarium. You see this look of being astonished. They want to explore, they want to know more, and this is the right moment that you start to introduce sciences, to let them see that they would like to be like those sciences. They want to follow the same path. They want to sort of follow the same course. And from within, they would adhere to studying sciences. And within summertime, you see groups of students who come here and do a lot of activities, very fruitful. They come back and they start talking about what they have seen, what they have witnessed, and what they have worked together. It's remarkable opportunity that the Library of Alexandria is contributing to our young generations. We thank Dr. Ismail Siraj-ed-Din and all the groups that are working in different activities of Alexandria that for all what they are doing to our young generations. Now we are in the process of establishing the Egypt-Japan University for Science and Technology at Burj Al Arab, which comes after, as an outcome of 7 years of negotiations between the governments of Egypt and Japan, with the contribution of 12 universities in Japan and 8 universities in Egypt, together with Mubarak City for Science and Technology, to establish a unique type of university addressing sciences and technology. We started to receive the first batch last February, presenting graduate studies in areas like communications and electronics, like robotics and mechatronics, energy and environment. And we are now recruiting the second batch that will study computer science, computer engineering, nanosciences, material technology. And we are looking for smaller number of students, but with scope that we join forces with distinguished scholars from Japan to avail the best research environment for our promising young researchers. So the work has already started. We are being granted 200 fadans in Burj Al Arab to start establishing the university, the Egypt-Japan University for Science and Technology, EJAST. And the competition for the construction has started here also with the full support of the Library of Alexandria. And we are looking forward to continue the construction of this very promising university that we hope to contribute strongly in promoting science and technology in Egypt and within this part of the world. Finally, I would like to thank Dr. Ismail Siraj-Din, the Library of Alexandria, for hosting this wonderful conference, and I wish all participants pleasant stay in Alexandria and fruitful conference. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Yusri Gamal. And now, normally, we would have had a lovely young lady who has been a driving force behind the Planetarium Science Center of the Library of Alexandria, and that I believe many of our guests know, Engineer Huda Al-Miqati. But Huda Al-Miqati, from the very beginning, has had as her right arm and close associate a real astronomer, Dr. Omar Fikri, who is representing the Library of Alexandria's Planetarium Science Center, who is therefore the official host of this conference, and who will be able also to extend our deep thanks and appreciation to the sponsors of this conference, in addition, of course, to the International Planetarium Society, whose conference this is. So, Dr. Omar Fikri, please.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Your Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to begin by extending a very warm welcome to our distinguished guests and participants from all over the world. Welcome to the Planetarium. Welcome to the 12th International Planetarium Society Conference that's held for the first time in Africa and the Middle East. So now we are all here. Back to Alexandria, the Cathedral of Astronomy. The idea of hosting this conference, starting at Melbourne in IBS 2004. And then when we presenting our proposal to host this important event, we had a dream to hold this event in Alexandria, and only in August 2007 in Rio de Janeiro, after a fierce and fair competition with our colleagues from China and the French, the dreams turned into reality. So from Alexandria to Valencia at the north, from Alexandria to Melbourne at the fast fast south east, from Alexandria to the fast south west, we are whole finally. It's a great enthusiasm and zeal that we started our work in organizing the IBS 2010, and zeal that we started our work in organizing IBS 2010. Our aim of hosting a remarkable conference for all our guests to be remembered. We always had our eyes on this day. When we will be welcoming here at the Library of Alexandria participants from 44 countries representing various cultures, civilizations, but sharing a passionate about astronomy and the planetarium field. Today, we are all here to revive the spirit of ancient Library of Alexandria, the platform of debates, discussions, exchange ideas, experience, and inspiration of enriched human heritage. Today, we are a positive IBS 2010. We'll push the cradle forward to the field of planetarium and astronomy. We would like also to thank all our sponsors and exhibitors for their generous support to the IPS 2010. Special acknowledgement to our hypergiant sponsors, Skyscan and Even and Sutherland, and also to the sober giant sponsor, RSA Cosmos. And now, according to our program or to the conference program, I would like to invite you to all to visit the conference exhibition. The coffee break after the conference exhibition inauguration will take place directly in the BA at 11. And please, back to here, sharp, please sharp, at 11:30 for the first keynote speaker, Dr. Professor Ismail Saragheddin. Thank you and welcome again.
So may I ask now everybody and the guests to join me in the exhibition. We're going to inaugurate the exhibition now and then enjoy some coffee and meet here again at 11:30. So exhibition first. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.